Ahmed III, Ottoman Turkish, Ahmed I Salis December 30, 1633, July 1, 1736, was Sultan of the Ottoman Empire and a son of Sultan Mehmed IV, 1648-87. His mother was Marpera Imatullah, Rabia Gulnas Valide Sultan, originally named of Maniavaria, who was an ethnic Bulgarian. He was born at Hajoglu Pazari, in Dobrua. He succeeded to the throne in 1703 on the abdication of his brother Mustafa II, 1695-1703. Nefzherli Damat Ibrahim Pasha and his daughter, Princess Hatice, wife of the former, directed the government from 1718-1730. A period referred to as the Tulip Era. Ahmed III cultivated good relations with France, doubtless in view of Russia's menacing attitude. In fact, both his wives were French women. He afforded refuge in Ottoman territory to Charles XII of Sweden, 1682-1718, after the Swedish defeat at the hands of Peter I of Russia, 1672-1725, in the Battle of Poltava of 1709. In 1710 Charles XII convinced Sultan Ahmed III to declare war against Russia, and the Ottoman forces under Boltak Mehmet Pasha won a major victory at the Battle of Prut. In the aftermath, Russia returned us off back to the Ottomans, agreed to demolish the fortress of Taganrog and others in the area, and to stop interfering in the affairs of the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth. Forced against his will into war with Russia, Ahmed III came nearer than any Ottoman sovereign before or since to breaking the power of his northern rival, whose armies his Grand Vizier Nefzherli Damat Ibrahim Pasha succeeded in completely surrounding at the Prut River campaign in 1711. The subsequent Ottoman victories against Russia enabled the Ottoman Empire to advance to Moscow, had the Sultan wished. However, this was halted as a report reached Constantinople that the Safavids were invading the Ottoman Empire, causing a period of panic, turning the Sultan's attention away from Russia. Sultan Ahmed III had become unpopular by reason of the excessive pomp and costly luxury in which he and his principal officers indulged. On September 20, 1730, a mutinous riot of 17 Janissaries, led by the Albanian Patrone Halil, was aided by the citizens as well as the military until it swelled into an insurrection in front of which the Sultan was forced to give up the throne. Ahmed voluntarily led his nephew Muhammad I, 1730-54, to the seat of sovereignty and paid allegiance to him as Sultan of the Empire. He then retired to the caves previously occupied by Muhammad and died at Tropkap Palace after 6 years of confinement. Character of Ahmed III's rule. The reign of Ahmed III, which had lasted for 27 years, although marked by the disasters of the Great Turkish War, was not unsuccessful. The recovery of Azov and the Mora, and the conquest of part of Persia, managed to counterbalance the Balkan territory ceded to the Habsburg monarchy through the Treaty of Passerowitz, after the Ottoman Empire was defeated in Austro-Turkish War of 1716-18. In 1716, he sent an army of 33,000 men to capture Corfu from the Republic of Venice. Ahmed III left the finances of the Ottoman Empire in the flourishing condition, which had remarkably been obtained without excessive taxation or extortion procedures. He was a cultivated patron of literature and art, and it was in his time that the first printing press authorized to use the Arabic or Turkish languages was set up in Constantinople, operated by Ibrahim Mutafarika. While the printing press had been introduced to Constantinople in 1480, all works published before 1729 were in Greek, Armenian, or Hebrew. It was in this reign that an important change in the government of the Danubian principalities was introduced. Previously, the Porti had appointed Hospodars, usually native Moldavian and Wallachian boyars, to administer those provinces. After the Russian campaign of 1711, during which Peter the Great found an ally in Moldavia Prince Dmitry Kantma, the Porti began overtly deputizing Phanariot Greeks in that region, and extended the system to Wallachia after Prince Stefan Cantacuzino established links with Eugene of Savoy. The Phanariots constituted a kind of demi-nobility, which supplied the Porti with functionaries in many important departments of the state. Relations with the Mughal Empire. Jahandar Shah. In the year 1712, the Mughal Emperor Jahandar Shah, a grandson of Aurangzeb, sent gifts to the Ottoman Sultan Ahmad III and referred to himself as the Ottoman Sultan's devoted admirer. Farrukh Siyar. The Mughal Emperor Farrukh Siyar, a grandson of Aurangzeb, is also known to have sent a letter to the Ottomans, but this time it was received by the Grand Vizier Nefzhali Damid Ibrahim Pasha, providing a graphic description of the efforts of the Mughal commander Said Husan Ali Khan Bahu against the Rajput and the Maratha rebellion. Marriages and issue. He married Amina, Emin, Mahrima Sultan and Rabia Sirmi Sultan. By the first wife he had Mustafa III and by the second wife he had Abdul Hamid I. A passage in Voltaire's Candide has the book's eponymous main character meet the deposed Ahmad III while on a ship from Venice to Constantinople. The Sultan is in the company of five other deposed European monarchs, and he tells Candide, who initially doubts his credentials, "I am not jesting, my name is Achmet III, for several years I was Sultan. I dethroned my brother, my nephew dethroned me, they cut off the heads of my viziers. I am ending my days in the old seraglio. My nephew, Sultan Mahmud, sometimes allows me to travel for my health, and I have come to spend the carnival at Venice." This episode was taken up by the modern Turkish writer Nedim Gürsel and made into the setting of his 2001 novel Le Voyage de Candide à Istanbul. In fact, there is no evidence of the deposed sultan being allowed to make such foreign travels, nor did Voltaire, or Gürsel, assert that it had any actual historical foundation.